Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about multiplication and division word problems. And the first one says Alex spent $16,500 for his car. Mallory spent $23,200 for her car. Lindsay spent $3,500. And Sydney spent $2,800 for her car. What was the average amount spent? To find the average, we want to add up everything that we're given and then divide by the number of add-ins or the number of things that we added. So what do we have in this problem? 16,500, 23,200, 3,500, and 2,800. And I left the dollar symbols off, but we are working with dollars here. And so notice when I wrote those, I lined those up nicely so that I have my ones and my tens and everything lined up. So this is 10, 20, and this is 5, 10, 16, and finally 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 4. So they spent a total of $46,000 on their cars, but way different. One person spent $2,800, the other person spent $23,000, so there's a very wide range of amounts spent. To figure out the average, we're going to take the $46,000 and divide by the number of people that were, number of add-ins, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to divide that by 4. 4 goes into 1, 4 goes into 4 once. 1 times 4 is 4. Then 6, 4 goes into 6 one time, 1 times 4 is 4. We're going to bring down the 0, 4 goes into 40, oh, sorry, I didn't subtract, that's 2, and bring down the 0. 4 goes into 25 times, and then I just have more zeros, so I can just bring those straight up. So it looks like they averaged $11,500. If I want to check that, I can check it by multiplying 4 times 0. 5 times 4 is 20, 4 plus 2 is 6, and 4 times 1 is 4. Sure enough, when I multiply that, I get 46,000. So the average amount spent was $11,500. Remember, you can always check division with multiplication. So that's how to find the average. Let's look at the next one. Bill has had 11 grandchildren. He wanted to share his $500 tax return with them. If he plans to give them each an equal share, but only wants to share whole dollar amounts, how much will each child get and how much money will be left over? So in this case, we're going to take $5,000 and we're going to split it up amongst his grandchildren. So is that a multiplication or a division? Well, hopefully you recognize that he's going to divide that money up amongst them. So that's going to be a division. We're going to divide by 11. How many times does 11 go into 50? Well, it goes 4 times because 4 times 11 is 44. Then I'm going to subtract and get 60. How many times does 11 go into 60? Well, that goes 5 times because 5 times 11 is 55. And then I'm back to 50. 11 goes into 50, as we said before, 4 times. 4 times 11 is 44. And that gives me 6. Now that's my remainder because I can't put 11 in there again. I'm not going out to the change or the cents because it says he only wants to give them whole dollar amounts. So what this tells me is that everybody's going to get $454 and Bill is going to have $6 left over. All right, so there's the two answers. They wanted to know how much is everybody going to get and how much would be left over. Again, we can check that by doing 454 times 11 to see if we get 5,000. Or we wouldn't get 5,000, we would after we added the 6, right? And the last one says, Bailey estimates that on average she pays $215 per month for electricity. How much would she spend in 1 year? Well, how many months are there in a year? The number of months in a year is 12. So we would take 215 times 12 to find out that answer. So that is you having to know a little bit about life in general there. 2 times 5 is 10. 1 times 2 is 2 plus 1 is 3. And 2 times 2 is 4. Put a 0. 1 times 5. 1 times 1 and 1 times 2. If we add those up, we get $2,580, and that's the amount that she spends in a typical year on electricity. All right, have a fantastic day.